Do you want to sync user accounts from your domain controller to Nextcloud while keeping the connection secure using LDAPS? In this video, I'll show you step-by-step how to configure Nextcloud to connect with Active Directory, verify the LDAPS certificate, and securely import users automatically. First, you need to have a Nextcloud server that's already up and running. If you haven't set it up yet, check out the installation video I've linked in the description below. Next, you need a domain controller that's already configured and contains user accounts in Active Directory. If you haven't set it up yet, check out the setup video linked in the description below. In this example, we will import all users from the organizational unit named Department into Nextcloud. Next, we will also prepare some supporting tools. The first one is PuTTY, which we'll use to SSH into the Nextcloud server. Next is WinSCP, a tool that allows us to access and transfer files between Windows and the Linux server. In addition, on your DNS server, make sure you already have an A record pointing to the Active Directory server. This ensures that Nextcloud can correctly resolve the domain controller's hostname when connecting over LDAPS. On the Nextcloud server, you also need to manually define a host entry for the domain controller. Specifically, add a line that maps the domain controller's IP address to the exact domain name used in the LDAPS certificate. Finally, make sure that from the Nextcloud server, you can ping the domain controller's FQDN. If the ping fails, double-check your host's file or DNS configuration before proceeding with the LDAPS setup. Next, we will install the certificate authority on the domain controller. This component is responsible for issuing and managing security certificates, which allows LDAPS to operate securely and with trusted authentication. Here, select Active Directory Certificate Services to install the Certificate Authority service on your domain controller. For the remaining options, just keep the default settings and click Next to continue. Then, click Install and wait for the installation to complete. After installing the certificate authority, we will proceed to issue an SSL certificate for the domain controller so it can use a secure LDAPS via port 636 connection. Here, check the certificate authority option and click Next to continue. Next, select Enterprise CA and click Next to continue. Continue by selecting Root CA and click Next to proceed. Here, enter a common name for the certificate authority. You can use your domain name or your organization's name, then click Next to continue. Next, select the validity period for the certificate. Typically, you can keep the default 5 years. Then click Next to continue. Finally, click Configure to start the installation and configuration of the certificate authority. Now, from Server Manager, go to the Tools menu and select Certification Authority to open the Certificate Management Console. Here, you'll see the certificate authority you just created listed. This confirms that the CA installation and initialization were successful. Next, after the certificate has been created, we'll export this certificate from the domain controller so that we can later import it into the Nextcloud server. Here, select Base64 encoded format to export the certificate in a format compatible with Linux systems. Next, choose the location to save the certificate file. You can save it to the desktop or a shared folder. After obtaining the certificate file, the next step is to use WinSCP to upload it to the Nextcloud server. For now, we'll upload the certificate file to the desktop directory on the Nextcloud server for easier access in the following steps. Now, reopen the SSH window and we'll install the certificate on the Nextcloud server so that the system can trust the LDAPS connection from the domain controller. Move to the desktop directory where we just uploaded the CA file. Next, rename the certificate file and copy it to the system's trusted certificate directory. Next, install the certificate you just copied by updating the trusted certificate list on the Nextcloud server. After updating the certificates, let's test the LDAPS connection to make sure that the Nextcloud server can securely communicate with the domain controller. If the result shows verify return code is OK, it means the certificate has been successfully verified and the LDAPS connection is working correctly. All right, everything is set up. Next, we'll synchronize users from Active Directory to Nextcloud. First, we'll create a dedicated account in Active Directory that Nextcloud will use to authenticate and query user information via LDAPS. Enter any username you prefer. This will be the service account that Nextcloud uses to connect to Active Directory. Next, set a password for this account and check the Password Never Expires option to ensure that Nextcloud can maintain a stable connection to the domain controller without interruptions caused by password expiration. All right, everything is ready. Now let's return to the Nextcloud interface to configure synchronization. From the left-hand menu, select LDAP-AD integration to open the configuration interface for connecting to the domain controller. In the host field, enter the fully qualified domain name of the domain controller. This is the domain name that Nextcloud will use to connect via LDAPS. Then, click Detect Port, and the system will automatically recognize port 636, which is the standard port for LDAPS connections. Next, in the User DN field, enter the distinguished name of the account we just created. Next, enter the password of the account in the password field. Next, enter the organizational unit from which you want to synchronize all accounts to Nextcloud. This limits the synchronization scope to the selected OU instead of the entire Active Directory. Then, click Testbase DN to check. If the result shows OK, it means that Nextcloud has successfully connected to the OU in Active Directory and is ready for user synchronization. In the next window, keep the default settings and click Continue to proceed with the configuration. Now, check the user list in Nextcloud to confirm that the accounts from the Active Directory are correctly recognized. If successful, you'll see all the accounts in the configured OU appear in the Nextcloud user list, ready for use. We have now completed synchronizing users from Active Directory to Nextcloud via LDAPS. We hope this video helps you save time and manage users more efficiently. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more helpful tutorials.